It's time to go inside Florida State football. This is the Jimbo Fisher Show. The Jimbo Fisher Show is brought to you by the Florida Lottery, proud sponsor of FSU Athletics, the Florida Department of Transportation, drive sober or get pulled over, the energy-saving conservation programs of TECO People's Gas, Camping World and Good Sam, your one-stop shop for everything RV, Coca-Cola Zero, real Coke taste and zero calories, The Gem Collection, finest quality jewelry, extraordinary service, and the best possible prices. SunTrust, the official bank of the Florida State Seminoles. Nick's Toggery, provider of Coach Fisher's wardrobe. By visitflorida.com.
Hello and welcome to the Jimbo Fisher Show. The news is great, Coach. Congratulations. An undefeated regular season and you move to the top of the polls. And I know there's a lot of work left, but nevertheless, congratulations on that and the win over your rivals.
Thank you. That was one of our goals. First of all is winning your rival game, your state championship. We call it state championship, being able to, you know, if you want to have other goals, win your conference and win the other thing, you have to win your state first. Then you have to win your conference and you have to do your national championships. But that was one of our first goals. We loved to have an undefeated season, which was a goal. And so we're gradually just knocking those off. We've got to take the next step now.
This Florida team, despite the way their season turned out, you knew going in that you were going to get a heck of an effort from Will Muschamp's team, and that's what you got from them.
No doubt. That is still a very talented football team. On offense, they've got a few more injuries and what goes on, but defensively, their front guys, I mean, they're going to play in the NFL. Their secondary guys, I mean, high NFL picks. I mean, they had a few linebackers that were banged up, but they have good players. They were coached extremely well. We knew it was going to be a very difficult game and was going to be a struggle. And then luckily, we made enough plays and then got the momentum of the game and played great defense, kept the pressure on them.
Yeah, I was going to say, given that you guys were locked in a tight game for a while, you had to be pleased with the no signs of panic on the road. You finally get a touchdown, and then from there it opened up.
It really did, and the kids kept great poise, knowing, and they made plays on us. I mean, they made plays, and like I say, we're coached very well, and we just kept making little adjustments here and there, and the guys just kept, as I say, sawing wood. They just kept going forward. They just kept pushing to the next play, and all of a sudden we made a play, made another play. Momentum got going, and they started getting some confidence, and then we were able to execute.
A big win for Florida State on the road over rival Florida. We will get to the highlights when we come back. Stay with us here on the Jimbo Fisher Show. Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Florida State at Florida. And Coach, you've had good success against your rivals in your tenure here, but you continue to just take it one game at a time. But what was really the mission or the focus conversation with the team leading up to kickoff?
Well, I think, just keep your emotions high. You got to match the intensity. We knew they'd come out very physical, very emotional early, but you can't get your emotions control the game. Execution was still going to win the game. Be high, but then be able to execute, keep your focus, and knew it was going to be physical. You got to make your mind that it was going to be a physical football game, and we had to make it that way, and then we knew they were going to be that way. Good kickoff here. They faked the reverse, and Pierre Ford gets the ball. Nice kickoff, Burke. A little bit low, line drived it. Of all the things he did all day, probably kickoffs were off just a hair from normal, but he kicked the ball extremely well. But again, good coverage here by Christian Jones. See his versatility, and great job here. They try to set the screen, blocking Christian in space, but, big linebackers, athletic, it's tough. And then we did a good job up front. Now, guys, Timmy Jernigan, Niall Lawrence, Christian Jones, Eddie Goldman, them guys inside just being men now. I mean, Telvin inside, Terrence Smith, good rush here. Jacoby, they got a nice twist game, hit a route, had third and long. Good tackle right there by LaMarcus Joyner, who played his normal great game, and just very proud of those guys. And early in the drive, we move it, throw a little flat route here. Devontae gets a catch, but they can run now. They covered us down in man coverage and made a nice play. And we had a little screen route. We missed a block. Didn't get up. Just field just a hair. We could have got outside. We had a big play, but there's KB. That's a little ridiculous there now. I mean, and that's what I'm talking about. That you need to get control of that early. Nice square in right here by 80. They're trying to be physical with him, but Rashad made a nice pledge and throw by Jameis right in the hole. Again, I got to hang on that ball 8 in the flat. Even though it's 3 or 4 yards, it just changes. Second 7 is a lot better than second 10. There's Bobby Hart. And we get the late hit. Darius Cummings, ex-player here, gets a late hit right there and gets 15 and kept our poise here. We had him beat deep. He underthrew it just a tad on the go. That's where we wanted to go. Underthrew it just a tad, and they made a nice play on the ball. And I'd say Pure Foy is a good corner. Kelvin Taylor there. getting up in there, and our guy in the line doing a good job. It's Terrence Smith, Eddie Goldman. What happened on this play? Eddie jumped offsides, and he stopped because he knew he was offsides and thought they were going to blow the whistle, and they did, and they blew it. They pushed him aside, and then Jalen Ramsey running him down with Darby, and they make a big play on the quarterback run, and actually they got down here and ended up missing the field. But good job, Terrence Smith, Telvin Smith, Christian Jones on the play right here. Get a high snap, and we're able to get back on him. Nice play right there. I can't tell quite who made that play from ground level, but guys just shooting back in there, making plays, and here they get a little sprint out trying to move the pocket. And Joyner does a great job of not going inside there and setting the edge of the defense, making him tuck up inside, and then we were able to rally to him. And they missed a field goal here, critical that they didn't get the points, and we take the next drive down. At least we get a field goal here. We missed a cut right. This ball, if it hits inside, it's going to be a big play. We have just total misrun by James, one of the few he had. Now, that's a great catch right here. Back inside. Oh, this is a drop by KB. I'm sorry. I thought he was going to Knicks, but KB's got to make that play. He had a great day, but he had a couple balls he could have held on to, too. Now we get the interference call again on Kenny Shaw by Hargraves. He held him. Now Nick Hare runs a double move on the corner. Great one-handed catch by Nick O'Leary. Boy, just keep. I'm going to tell you what. Nick not only caught the ball well, but he had some other throws to him. Blocking. Nick is becoming a complete tight end. Now we're moving the ball. Good play by them. Devontae Freeman. Guys blocking downfield. We got pressure. We're getting ready to throw it right here, and the receiver changed us up. We thought he was going to cut in. He went out. Made him hold the ball. They tipped it. We got a sack. But then old Roberto Aguayo coming in. 50-yarder, 49-yarder, however. I mean, into the wind, and that could have been good from another 15 yards. I mean, Roberto hit it great and just accurate and critical. We got on the board first. Nice kickoff here. They're trying to bring it back to the field. Here's Marcus Allegue. He's had an outstanding year on special teams for us. Karlos Williams being outstanding. Done a great job. Guys, just, all those guys, different roles they're expanding into. There you go, Telvin and Christian and Timmy Jernigan, those guys inside, and just making Eddie Goldman, just making good plays. Keep pushing the pocket. Here they get a nice crossing route, and they get it inside there. Jalen Ramsey got to cut that a little bit better, but they made a nice play trying to power up inside. Our guys are doing it, rallying to the football. Good job to Marcus Joyner. Keeps making plays. Old 20. Good dump off in the flat. They get a little screen, but good Telvin gets around, and P.J. Williams did a nice job. Again, P.J., I thought Ronald Darby both played outstanding game. Mario Weber, you talk about bringing power and bringing heat to the party down inside now. I mean, he's changing that line of scrimmage and growing. Nate Andrews in the ball game again, having an outstanding freshman year. And I mean, just being outstanding overall. Their punter now did a nice job, and they pinned us back. Luckily, this one got in the end zone, but we get it coming out. Nice run. We miss a block. We get this block right here. It's inch. This ball, and our runs early, just one guy, one different lineman here and there. We're inches from coming out on a lot of these plays. Now they get pressure on a twist and cause Jameis to run out, but he did a nice job of protecting the ball in the pocket, getting out of there, getting a couple little runs, got sacked once or twice, but didn't turn that football over with the pressure. And here, on third down, he gets rid of it, tries to get it out to a square end route, and they get pressure. And again, we only had two punts on the day. Casey didn't get this one quite as good, but we got a good roll on the day. And again, Phil Dumar and those guys doing a good job snapping the ball and covering. They get speed sweep going to the edge, but we did a great job of keeping edge, contained on the day. Again, Terrence Brooks has had an outstanding year for us, really playing well. Again, got pressure again. Nice open field tackle here by Jalen Rand. That's another thing we did in this game very well. Tackled well in open space. And, they're just inches short here on the fourth down. They go for it and then end up making it. It's a big gamble there, but they got down inside, and they keep driving the football. Again, we got great pressure. Again, contained by Joyner, closing, making that ball come out quick, and just accelerating to the quarterback. Mario Weber's getting pressure. There's Jacoby, who had an outstanding game, an outstanding year. Again, forcing pressure on that one, constantly getting it out of there. Now, this ends up being a huge drive in the game. We only had the ball five times the first half, and they get it on the daggone one. They did a great job of getting that ball pinned back. And this one, I'm going to tell you, we talk about big plays. This was a huge play in the game. Second and 10 on the one, we pop a 9-yard run and get it to a third and short, and then we're able to pick up the short yardage. Then we get a nice little power play here and just mix up a little run, get a little physical. Just, 3-4 yard run, 3-yard run. Those are all good plays. You can't be impatient. This play here with engine. Fullback's got to take the edge off that tackle, and that's a big play. Again, third down pickup. We missed a block on the backside. Jameis stood in there and threw a strike with a guy running right down the barrel of the gun right at him, boy. That's big time. And here goes back up to KB. We just missed. I mean, just he threw the ball out. Jameis threw it just a hair outside. We need it more inside. Now we get a sack here on a naked, which should never happen. This should never happen and get the penetration. This is not Jameis' fault. We missed a block up front. And then third and 25, you talk about a critical play. Watch this catch right here by Kenny Shaw and takes the hit, stands tall, gets up. Now that's what a big-time player does, makes a play. Now we're able to come back right here, and then a great back shoulder throw right here on a go route to KB. They were playing over the top of him. And KB just keeps growing up and being that force that we all know he can be. Watch his slant route. Catch a slant inside the slot. One, two, three, four, and then runs away. That's KB being KB. That's what we imagine he can do. And he is learning to be so consistent in the way he can dominate a football game. Or, I mean, just proud. That was just effort. That was a mindset right there that I'm going to get it done. Now, this Roberto here, we tried to overkick the daggone ball, give him field position coming back, and we can't do that. But, again, keeping good pursuit and also keeping a good edge on the defense. Guys rallying to the football here. Defense did a tremendous job on that. Again, I'm going to tell you what, is that Mario Edwards? That guy is evolving into the player that we truly believe he can be. This guy is turning into a force. Watch his tackle. Third and five. Right there, Ronald Darby on an open field skill guy in space making a tackle. That's big time. I mean, that's a big time play. Now we fake, get the bubble play out here, get it to Rashad. We miss a block inside, but it was a really nice job. And we start the vertical game right here. And we had a crossing route. We had to whip it back outside. Nice kill and catch. We're in 2 minute, again, before the half, which we do so well. And on third down, again, Nick O'Leary on the option route down inside. Now Nick just becoming that steady Eddie guy, just makes plays for us consistently. Then we get a one-on-one on the backside, get KB. He goes straight to it, and KB gets by him on a go route, and then KB being KB. We get two quick scores again right before the half. Get up three scores. Being up three scores is critical, and I'm going to tell you, that guy right there keeps evolving now. You're talking about got a chance to be with that whole group of receivers now, just being one of the great groups that's ever played here. Get a little squib, and Patton, he's a dangerous guy now. When he gets the ball, you got to know where he's at and get your hands on him. He almost pops one out here for half, but we're able to go up 17-0, which is very critical. And got the momentum the last two drives of the half, scored three out of five drives in the first half, and very proud of our guys, get momentum going in the locker room.
Nine catches for over 200 yards for Kelvin Benjamin in the game, three touchdowns. Obviously, you knew the potential was there. What was it specifically about this matchup where it all came together for
him?
Well,
I think it's been coming together for the second half of this year. The consistency in his routes, he's been blocking, doing those things, but he's just becoming such a consistent guy, along with Rashad, and along with Kenny, and along with Nick. And then he has that size and speed to be overpowering at times when you play him one-on-one. It's them, you against him, and he took over.
The big play, I'm going to say plays of the first half, because we're going to go with two here.
Yes.
Part of that length of the field drive, where you got your first touchdown, the first one was a Kenny Shaw catch, the next one was Kelvin Benjamin.
Exactly right. Kenny on third and 25, catches the ball in the middle of the field, knowing he's going to get hit, takes a shot, gets right up, goes the next play. We get momentum in the game, start playing, and KB catches a big, about a 12-yard slant route, breaks three tackles, runs away from everybody, and runs over everybody, gets us up and gets that momentum and takes. It's like all of a sudden the monkey got off our back and we relaxed and just started playing and we're able to execute.
Those big plays sponsored by Gem Collection. All right, there's still more big plays ahead when we get to the second half highlights. Those are straight ahead. Stay with us here on the Jimbo Fisher Show.
Buckle your chin straps. It's time for Inside the Helmet, presented by Napleton Infinity.
Reggie Northrup. I'm a sophomore. I play linebacker. I come from Jacksonville, Florida, First Coast High School.
Mitchell on the keeper. Reggie Northrup makes the stop.
My parents was trying to get me into something. Just get me started off, something to do after school. And I wasn't the best at it. It was a rough time. My first 3-4 years was real rough, I wasn't the best athlete, and I used to, I wasn't as aggressive as I am now. And a lot of my teammates used to pick on me, but I mean, over the years, I got tired of that and I got better and better, but my first game was, it was funny, because I used to not want to play, and my mom, she used to bribe me and my little brother to, she'd bribe us $5 to go to practice and play. And then after the game, she'd give us $5, so. My mom and my dad, they won't be here for me from thick and thin. So, my dad, he's helped me so much along the way, becoming a man and, an athlete. Great athlete, and football all around. And my mother, she always been that support system, and she just always been support, always in my corner, no matter what the issue was. Oh, I always wanted to be a professional football player. Yeah, from day one, even when I was in my, sorry days of football, where I ain't really, when grass ain't really like doing it, That was always my dream. I'm a character. I can say that, you know. I just try to, you know, I'm very different from everybody else, personality-wise. You know, I just like to have a good time, I would say. Oh, me, hands down. Hands down. Little something. A lot of that comes with hitting people hard. It's like, it all gotta be like, a lot of it's mental, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's good to have the technique along with it, but you know, the mental is that extra. So, I mean, I bring that to the table a lot. And, you know, high school, I wrestled, so, you know, that helped me a lot with, you know, my explosiveness and, you know, just my center of gravity, so. You know, the tradition overall, you know, game day experience, just breathtaking. It feels good to go run through that tunnel every Saturday and put on that green and gold jersey and slap that attitude sign before we go out on that field. It's just, do something, and yeah, watching, you know, Chief Osceola come out and plant that spear in the middle of the field. I'll do like portraits, or I'll draw like football, you know, players and actions and stuff like that. I've been drawing for a long time, since elementary school.
Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Tom Block and Coach Fisher. Coach, 17-0 at the half, and you get the ball to start the second half, and I know you want to just go ahead and put more points on the board, continue to apply the pressure.
We really do, and we didn't get a good return here, though. We missed a block and got the ball about the 18-yard line, which is disappointing because Kermit's wasn't his fault. We did usually have some better returns than that. And get a nice run here, but we should have got more out of this. There's more up in there, and we missed a ball. I mean, that should have been an 8- or 10-yard run right there. And again, now right here, we have a good drive. Now, this is the third down. They knocked away. Second down, we had a miscommunication with Nick and Jameis and just cost us the drive. And, you know, that happens sometimes when you get an option route. But those two have been playing very well. And then they get it. We get great coverage again on the ball. And then the big thing is right here. They get a pass, and Mario Webb was right here causing the fumble. We get a turnover, and it just takes the momentum of the game. Everybody played dead right there. We got to jump on that football. And I'm glad, again, Mr. Alert, 22, gets it there, and we get the ball coming back the second half. And able to drive down here. We end up getting a field goal. But look at there, KB. Guy's all over. You can't cover a guy better than that. But size. His size gets him open. Great throw. Great catch. Thought we'd have more yards here on this play. I thought we'd get it outside. But again, nice 3-4 yard run. A little bit extra there. I thought was unnecessary. But we missed it. Nick got a little option right inside. We get it. We get a 3rd and 3. We get a penalty here. Call the center just flinched. And then on 3rd and 8, we just gets his hand. And we had the route open. Him and KB both on the slant. Jameis tried the inside guy. Guy got his hand on it. Like we didn't get a pick, but a close to a catch. But then Roberto again hits that field goal. We up 20-0, get momentum of the game back. Very proud of the guys. Nice kickoff here. And I think they get a good return. We actually missed this kickoff here. I'm sorry. We need to kick that ball in the corner a little more. We got it misplaced. Where that ball's kicked is critical to our coverage. And we were off just a hair yesterday at times on this. But again, our front doing such a good job. There's Niall Lawrence, who's getting better and better. And Reggie Northrup in the ball game. We're playing, making plays. Again, high snap, cost. Well, you get those things, it's costly. And Christian Jones getting him a tackle for loss and just doing a great job. Another little high snap. Timmy Jernigan getting pressure, making that ball come out. Now we got tackling, get him down in space. Short of the first down, great. Great job of being smart, knowing where it's at. We get a nice stretch run right here. Good run by Devontae Freeman again. I thought had another outstanding day. And our line really started picking things up after that first series two and played well. Jameis on 3rd down. Had a chance to throw him, saw a big hole and scrambled. Now here, there you go, get down. Very smart, got the first down. And then we get a play action here. And I thought we might get Nick or the backside, and they left KB one-on-one. We got it over the top. Now watch him go get this ball for a big guy. I mean, stretches out, goes and gets that football, and just makes a great effort. That's what, and that ball's in the air, that's what guys do. They just can accelerate to that football. Great, watch a block right there by Chad Avery. Their tackle came free on the backside. Chad knocks him off, allows us to walk in the end zone untouched. And now we're up four scores and very critical in the game and just keeping the momentum of the game. And the guys just keep, you know, we're starting to score and getting that rhythm on offense.
Starting to wear down their defense, too, as the game went on.
Yes, yes. Good, nice kick right here in the corner. And I think we get a nice stop right here about the 18, 19-yard line. Guys are covering well. Great job. There's Nigel Terrell, E.J. Levenberry making a play right there. Boy, he's going to be a good player, too, now. Again, getting pressure, throwing that ball. Caught that ball for a loss. They caught that ball for a loss. And this is the big one right here. Third and 10. Daggone, we got to have the linebacker squeeze that back so he doesn't get the screen off. And they made a nice play by their quarterback, get that ball off and hit a big screen play on third and 10. They had a couple big conversions. We had a penalty in here. Again, this is actually, Telvin got cracked here. The corner's got to make a call and stay put, and then we can make that play. Then we get shook up here, and Telvin, and we get a little shook up. Guys are pushing and shoving, and we get a 15-yard penalty, and we don't need to do that. We do not need to do that. We need to be a lot smarter. And we had two of those yesterday that are, I don't care what happens. You don't do that. They're moving the ball. It's free yards for those guys. And we have one on offense, one on defense. Good job here. PJ getting good coverage, covering down on the guy. Guys getting pressure, making that ball come out. Hey, that was a fourth down play. We called timeout, thought we had him, and Joyner had him covered and tripped up and lost his footing and fell. And then they run a little reverse right here and gets it back with some misdirection. And, you know, Florida doing a nice job of moving the football. Here they get a nice play action, get our backer picked, and get the ball in the flat. And just a good throw and catch by them, and the fullback made a nice play.
They sort of emptied the kitchen sink on that drive.
They did. But here's what I like. We responded right back. And I'm going to tell you what, this guy came in there and was running that football hard now. We started doing a better job up front, got control of things, and just playing with more consistency up front. And again, I can say they're good players. Those guys are all 44. All those guys are playing in the NFL now. And this is, well, KB, you see him turn his head? He started to run with the ball right before he caught it, wanted it a little bit too much. You know what we did next play? Had a one-on-one, went right back to him. There you go. That's a sign of a good player. Put the mistake behind you, go the next play, makes another big play. And James here, boy, he just keeps pounding that rock and running hard, and that big body, boy, just wears on his fresh legs. Nice job here. Again, just keeps pounding. That's when we played before, we had a penalty by Cam that we didn't. Even though they do something, we can't retaliate back, and we're always getting caught. Nice third down pickup here. We actually could have scored on this. He had to throw around the official and made him throw it behind him just a hair. Nice catch by Rashad. Had a nice job catching the ball all day. Again, there's that good hard yards by 32. Just watch the tackles he breaks, how hard it is to get him on the ground. Being physical down that goal line. Here we're on a nice play action. I thought he could have really hit the fullback in the flat, but no, he made a choice not to. But again, being smart with the ball, scrambling around, got to make sure he gets down. But I tell you what, he's a physical runner now. He's a big guy. And here we go. Watch this catch. Throw a back shoulder hitch fade. And KB throws on his other shoulder, just spins his head in one motion, turns his hands, makes the play. And I'm going to tell you, folks, that looks easy. It is not. That's extremely hard and very difficult. His ball skills were tremendous.
You said it exactly right. He made it look easy.
He makes everything look easy. And he'll drop one here, too, with concentration to take his head off. But, man, he is just becoming a great player, as all of our wideouts are doing a great job. Here we now we're starting to get pressure and doing a great job of tackling, getting guys in front of us, getting them on the ground, eating the clock, making them eat the clock, but not giving up big plays. The ball, the front four guys are making that ball come out, and there we go. Mario Webb, the guy's falling back in, not losing rush lanes. Very critical and playing with a lot of discipline. Here we go. Nice job on fourth down. Caused a fumble. It was fourth down. We got to stop anyway. And our guys, you know, Nate Andrews, again, doing a great job. Kobe McDaniel, Mario Webb, was the whole crew up there. Monte McCall, everybody. Now we're just going to start pounding. We want to run the ball, eat some clock, and try to, you know, get some points if we get them. But big thing, we want to eat clock and control the football game up front. Again, Wilder just keeps running and running. And I mean, three-yard runs become six-yard runs, seven-yard runs, the strength and the power. Here, well, him and Jameis got their feet tangled up right here. We had a nice play right there. Thought we had a big play. But third down, I'm going to tell you, Karlos makes a great run. If he stays outside just a hair more on that block, he may come out there and score. But nice hard run. Third down, center's throwing it. We just went ahead and kicked it, and Roberto hits it, and we're up 37-7, makes it, 30 points, and the clock's dwindling down. Again, get the ball in front of you, get him on the ground. Nate Andrews, Marquez White, boy, he's going to be a good player, too. Let's get Dan Hicks in the ball game. Great job, Terrence Smith. Great job here. Who is that? All the Marcus Brutus doing a great job. And we're running out the ball here. Karlos, again, another good, hard, tough run. again, it's Karlos, those 2 yard runs become 5 yard runs, 6 yard. He and those big backs, man, they keep pounding you. Again, just keep pounding up in there. Look at that. Just keep being strong, pounding that ball. Sean McGuire in the game along with the other guys, and you know, good ball game, good win. Will's a good football coach, and they got good players.
This senior class goes 3-1 against Florida. You finish the regular season unbeaten. Again, congratulations at 12-0. Number one in the country. What's different? How does that feel?
I mean, it's great, and that's where you want to be, but you can't worry about that. That's something that's happened in the past. We have to take care of this week, prepare and play, and we can't let that be a factor in how we prepare, play, and think about this next game.
And we'll look ahead to that next game momentarily. But the big play of the second half, sponsored by Xfinity. Coach, this one belongs to the defense.
Yes.
After you punted on the initial drive of the second half, the defense went and got the ball back for you.
They really did. Mario Edwards on the first play. Knew they were going to have to be aggressive and come back at us. Mario gets pressure, catches him as he's getting the ball back before his arm goes forward, causes a fumble, changes the whole momentum the second half. Again, we get it, get down, get a field goal, even though we don't get a touchdown, get momentum, just get control of the game again. It was a critical play in the game by Mario.
Next up, the ACC championship game for Florida State, and we now know who will be representing the Coastal Division. It's a great story there, the Duke Blue Devils. We'll talk about Coach Cutcliffe and Duke on the other side of this break. Stay with us. A preview of the ACC championship game is up next.
Let's go behind the scenes of Seminole football with this week's Seminole Insider, presented by Hyundai.
We got to play at a level, we got to practice at an elite level. We play at an elite level. Don't drop it no matter what you do. The standard isn't on him, it's on us. Our opponent has no face. We talk about it all the time. I'm going to tell you something. I just went out there and saw a group of seniors. They've laid a foundation here with the first class I was ever bring in here. And we're doing what we do because of those guys. Because they've had their will upon y'all. And they've set a standard. It's amazing. It's the culture and what we've done. As far as how we've changed and how you play. How I love to come to work every day, how I love to coach this group, because you do whatever we ask you to do. Tremendous group of guys. Tremendous group of guys. You play football the way it's supposed to be played. You respect the game because you work at it. You study it. And then you play it with the most passionate heart of any team I've been around. Nothing changes today, no matter what you do. You guys have set a standard. You're going to set a standard for when they go back and say, that is FSU football. That's the standard. That's the standard by which we play, this team plays, and how it's done. It's been fun. You lock in, you play, guys. Our standard doesn't go. We're right here. Stay, start fast. Find you a crumb. Nothing changes, guys. Find a crumb, be hungry. Play hungry with a chip on your shoulder and with the edge. Go higher. If anything happens, just go higher. Take the game higher. At the end, have grit. Sink your teeth down into it, bite into it, and play the game the way it's supposed to be played.
Let's step into the film room. It's time for Seminole Playmakers.
All right, Karlos, before we get to the film from the ACC Championship game, what was the excitement level of you guys when you had clinched that against Maryland and knew you'd be going?
It was great. It was great going up there and really putting it to Maryland, really playing a tough, hard game. And in that type of environment, we knew they were going to run the ball. We knew they were going to be pretty much one-dimensional. And practicing that all week, Coach Stoops really did a great job of zeroing in on that that quarterback. He's going to be a big runner. Really not a great thrower, but they're going to try it, you know, in the second half, you know, try a couple trick plays. But going into that game, we really focus on shutting down the offensive line, shutting down the run game, and we made sure they stay inside the tackles, you know, playing outside in rather than playing inside out.
Yeah, the good news is you're in the game. The bad news is you play against something completely different than what you've seen all season in Georgia Tech. Just how difficult is it to prepare for that in 1 week's time?
It's crazy to prepare for an offense you face maybe once every 3 years. You don't get to see this offense a lot. You know, only a couple teams in the NCAA run this offense, Air Force, Navy, in Georgia Tech. It's very difficult. You know, they have a lot of speed guys. They have a great fullback. Their B-back, I think that's what they call it. Their offensive line have very wide splits, so our D-line have to be very spaced out, play gap assignment, and have to be very disciplined when you play a team like this. I think we played very well, and, you know, a lot of young guys on the field stepped up and made a lot of plays this game.
All right, let's go to the film. And right here, we have a play from the fourth quarter. Just how different is your alignment to face this offense than it might be in a typical game?
As you can see right here, Joyner's down closer to the line of scrimmage usually than he usually would be. You know, our safeties are pretty close. Our middle linebacker, my brother Vince, is backed up 10 yards away from the ball, so he can see the flow pattern in case it's a reverse option. And me and Christian playing outside of defensive ends for contained reasons. You know, easier to hit the dive coming down on the angle, having our D tackles play over the guards and really crashing the inside, taking up the two guards and the center. You know, it's basically we play very, very disciplined. You know, our two ends, Bjorn and Mario, played a great job on the tackles, dominating the tackles, and also playing off the dive and off the pitch, man, the whole night. You know, our corners outside were basically man-on-man, and they didn't really have a passing game. So, you know, we really shut it down, and, you know, the scheme was crisp, I could say. From day one, we went out there with a great attitude about shutting down the run game, and, you know, it was just a great experience playing at my first time playing at linebacker.
All right, go through this play and tell me what you're reading.
Right now, I'll be reading the guard. The guard goes down, tackle, and I stop it there because, as you can see, the guard's trying to get to the backside backer. Vince is coming over top. Let me rewind it for a second. Let me run it slow. As you can see, Vince is trying to get outside the guard, me hitting the gap. It's basically a fullback trap. The guard's trying to release, get around to the backside backer, which is Vince, the middle backer in this case, but Vince slips it, gives me the free passageway because I'm reading nothing but the fullback, and you have Mario playing the quarterback off the dive, and our safety help coming from Tyler Hunter's the pitch man, one-on-one from the corner. So it's pretty much, you know, a tackle guaranteed either way. You have two free linebackers, a backside backer coming from behind, Davis ends playing the tackle perfectly, and it's a one-on-one with the pitch man and one-on-one with the receiver. So the play pretty much broke down in our favor and ends up being a tackle for a minimum gain.
How important when you're playing the option is discipline?
Real discipline because, you know, it's a lot of reverse options coming out now. A lot of faster quarterbacks, more agile quarterbacks come out. That lead, the quarterback now for Georgia Tech, is bigger, faster than the quarterback they had last year. He can run. He can throw. I guarantee they're going to switch it up a little bit with him this year. But you get a lot of reverse options, a lot of more speed, power option with these guys. And you really have to play disciplined football because Sims, their fullback, had a very good game. I had a very good game, very disciplined, hit the holes hard. They're very good blockers on the edge. They're very, very fast with their wing backs. You know, you got to make sure you're playing the keys right. And the offensive lineman had very big splits. So reading those guards, reading the knuckles on the guards, you know, their alignment was very, very difficult. But also, you know, we played very, very disciplined the whole game. And the game plan was to shut down the run, and we did that.
All right, let's move to the next play. It was the end of the fourth quarter. I'm sure you remember this one quite fondly. They have a shot to come back and get a win at the end, but on this play, you're able to get the interception. Let's talk me through this one.
This play was really, really scary, I would have to say, because, you know, it's crunch time, first time in ACC championship. My stomach was I had butterflies like no other. It was worse than my first game ever playing football as a little kid. I had my brother next to me. He said, look, you got the back. You got the wing back. I'm covering next to you. If you need help, I got you. Just let me know. And I told him I got it. And, you know, it kind of played out in my favor. The couple plays before, they ran the same play and caught the ball short of the first down on me. And it was kind of a downer because, you know, we almost had a three and out right then. But, you know, I picked myself back up, made sure I was in the right place at the right time. And, you know, I tried to tip the ball down, but luckily it stayed in the air for me. I got the pick.
All right, take me through it.
As you start off, reading the quarterback, dropping over top of the wing back, and he broke early, I broke early, and you see I reached in and tipped the ball away, and luckily I came out on top with it, and you see Bjorn get down, the whole sideline's yelling at me to get down, but I made the decision just to run until somebody hit me, and, you know, finally, when I stepped out of bounds, I knew it was over. It was just a big, big sigh of relief, like, we did it. As a team, we did it. And from the back view, you can definitely see me and Vince reading it, playing off the wing, eyes go directly to him. As he cut underneath him, and I just try to get a hand in there. As I slipped my hand underneath, I knew I could pick it. And time I caught it, Bjorn was like, get down. And it's just a great feeling to know that, you know, the guys on the team, on the field with you were really after the same thing. And time, like I said before, time I stepped out of bounds, I knew it was a victory, and it just felt good, you know, to celebrate with my teammates. And me and my brother shared a moment we've never shared before in life. We actually cried on the football field together. And that's something I was very proud of, to send my brother to a BCS bowl game.
Time to look ahead. The ACC championship game is next, and this preview is sponsored by Florida Farm Bureau. And Coach, Duke, not a team that you faced this year, but certainly you have faced David Cutcliffe over the years, and he's just done a terrific job with this program.
He really has it, Duke. We've played him the last 2 years, and you know, he's done an outstanding job. He's really built that program. Got him. They've won 8 games in a row. They're 10-2, coming in with a lot of momentum, a lot of confidence, and again, we'll have to play our A game. We'll have to be ready to play.
I think the confidence thing that you touch on there, they were down 20 points or so second half against Virginia, and they rallied. That was early in their winning streak. And since then, they just have this sort of feeling of invincibility, which is good for them.
It is, and you grow, and you get learn to make them plays, and you know that you're what you're capable of, and you get confidence. And I think that's what they have, just like we do. And so it ought to be a great game.
They're a little unconventional defensively. Give us a sort of layman's terms on what they do that's different.
Well, it's not as everybody says they're different. They're 4-2-5, and it's really a nickel defense. So a lot of people play that now. Believe it or not, it's more common now than people think it's different. And that's a common thing that's going on. We were a base 4-2-5 last year, actually, believe that or not. And so it's very similar in a lot of coverages and things we went against a year ago. So we'll know how to go against it.
And now that you're number one and things have changed, they really haven't changed. You've just got to take care of the preparation this week.
It doesn't matter. You know, if you're number one, number 10, whatever. The only thing we got to control is the game we have this week. We got to prepare well, play well, have the guys mentally physically ready to go.
All right, sounds good. 8 o'clock from Charlotte on Saturday night. That's when FSU will meet Duke and try to make it back-to-back ACC championship. We'll step aside. Some final thoughts coming up on the other side of this break here in the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, one more game to go for now, but it's been a long stretch even with two bye weeks, and I know there's, you know, maybe, I don't know if it's easier or more difficult with everything that surrounds the program right now in terms of national title talk and all that sort of thing, but mentally, you just got to lock in for one more week at present, take care of Duke.
Exactly right, and again, I say it all the time, it's the process and what we believe, and it's all we can control. I mean, no matter what you're ranked or whatever, you have to play well this week, and that's all we can do, and we have to prepare well so we can play well and have a great week of practice.
All right, and then Florida State will head to Charlotte, take on the Duke Blue Devils, and work on a second consecutive ACC championship. Thanks so much for joining us on the Jimbo Fisher Show, and we'll see you next time.
The Jimbo Fisher Show has been brought to you by the Florida Lottery, proud sponsor of FSU Athletics, the Florida Department of Transportation, drive sober or get pulled over, the energy-saving conservation programs of TECO People's Gas, Camping World and Good Sam, your one-stop shop for everything RV, Coca-Cola Zero, real Coke taste and zero calories, the Gem Collection, finest quality jewelry, extraordinary service, and the best possible prices. SunTrust, the official bank of the Florida State Seminoles. Nick's Toggery, provider of Coach Fisher's wardrobe. By visitflorida.com. Join us next week for another in-depth look at Florida State football.